Yes, you bumbling boob, it is I, Skeletor, back again with another review. Meh! I had to do that. That was inevitable. You saw that coming from a He-Man review. But with that being said, hey guys, the Lord here, back again with another Mattel. I know, it's amazing. They finally grew some brains and decided to use that gold mine they've been sitting on for however many years. Again, I'm not sure about all that. But today we're taking a look at the Master of the Universe Origin Skeletor. And yes, I am very excited about this figure. This figure is amazing. It looks awesome. One nitpicky kind of thing I have against it. Other than that, it's amazing. And it's Skeletor. So one of my childhood idols, reimagined in yet another plastic form. I have a lot of Skeletors, I've noticed. I have this one. I have a couple I'll bring up for comparison towards the end of the video. I have my 2000 X one from when I was a kid. I have the Mega Constructs. I have the Loyal Subjects kicking around somewhere. The only one I don't really have is a Funko Pop or the World's Smallest. Is that what it's called? I don't know. It's something some people should stitch to their underwear, but that's besides the point. But inside joke for those of you who don't know. But Skeletor comes with the same mini comic as He-Man. I'm not going to go through it again. I already flipped through it during the He-Man review. But on the back, you can see all the stuff you can't find at Walmart because, well, Walmart. But regardless, we're not talking about Walmart. We're talking about this freaking awesome figure that just so happens to come from Walmart, at least for now. They're going to fix that in the future because once the year is over, floodgates will open, hopefully. And, these will be everywhere. You will not be able to escape the wrath of this awesome head sculpt. I don't know. I like this head sculpt. I think it's cool. Mine looks very unhappy to be here. It's very PO'd. But he's all... Like, this is the hands over his arms above his head, holding the Havoc Staff pose as he's about to blast He-Man into some dark abyss of no return. Yeah, we went there. But I think it's cool. I know that the prototype, the paint, was probably a little better, which they could fix. I mean, it's always a possibility. But here's the thing. It's Skeletor. It's here. It's now. It's cool. And I like it. I think it's awesome. He comes with his trusty Havoc Staff, which, as you can see, or could see, I should say, from the beginning of the video, he can dual wield. I mean, I don't have a lot of Skeletors I can do this. Maybe the Constructs can, but I know the Loyal Subjects can't. I don't even think the Classics one can, because of the way the handle gets towards the end of the staff here. But it looks, I always thought this looked like Mickey Mouse. I mean, the way the horns are curved, the way the skull is, it looks like Mickey Mouse. He killed Mickey Mouse and stuck his head on a stick and shoots lasers from it. How effed up is that? He is the evil lord of destruction anyways, so destroying your childhood is probably on his to-do list. He also comes with the power sword, the quote-unquote female half, wooga wooga. The idea here is you're supposed to be able to take these, snap them together like so. And now you can unlock the secrets of Castle Grayskull, which we do not yet have. Now, I think they should put a peg up towards the end here, like where the tips kind of are, because, just kind of splays out towards the end. It's not really effective. I guess I could warp He-Man's, because I think his is a little warped, but it's not worth my time, because I don't display He-Man holding the sword. I stick it in the hold her on his back and don't really look at it. So there's the purple sword, really cool. And then back to Skeletor and his giant back gap. Let's take some notes here. The original He-Man figure had this back gap. What does the Origins figure have? No back gap. Although with He-Man, you kind of get away with it because it is a harness. Skeletor, it's supposed to be armor that wraps around, like, all the way. And unfortunately, he just gets a derpy chest plate, half his shoulders, and a big old back gap. I love this figure, Mattel, I really do, but you kind of screwed up there. I don't like this giant gappy mess. It just doesn't look right. On He-Man, I could let it slide, but they didn't do it on He-Man, so I didn't have to let it slide. On this guy, I can't let that slide. That just looks bad. But whatever, I suppose. But articulation on this guy, he's got the double ball peg in the head, and you can get a lot of attitude on this because he doesn't have some ridiculous-looking Dutch boy hair. So he can look up really far. He can look down quite a bit. He can tilt side to side, like really tilt. Like, hey man, what's wrong with you, bruh? yeah, that's just really cool. You can get a lot of expression out of this, and then of course you can rotate it. Shoulders go out to the side again, right angle to the body. It can rotate as well, but of course, you gotta use that hinge or else it looks a little funny because it is at an angle. Single hinge at the elbow, swivel at the elbow, swivel at the wrist, hinge at the wrist, swivel at the waist. He's got his little belt there so the waist can't be loose, and that is awesome. T-jointed hips go out to the side, right angle to the body, which is awesome. They do kick forward and back a little bit, but not too far. Single joint at the knee gives you about 90, and swivels as well. And then he's got a boot cut, and then a single hinge at the foot with a rocker. And I still feel like the feet are a little small. I don't know, it just looks a little weird, but whatever. And then he's got the turn your head and cough hand on this side, or, you know, he could be shooting a ball of flame at He-Man's pretty face. So, yeah, that is Skeletor in a nutshell, really. And he is amazing. I love this figure. Top 10 of the year so far, which is kind of surprising because I thought for sure the Frank Langella one was going to beat this one out. But no, I'm having way more fun with this. Probably because I could pose it. That always helps. I like to pose figures. I'm a bit of a poser that way. And, it's amazing. I love this figure. It's so simplistic, but it's so cool. I can't wait for the Keldor to come out, because that's my jam. That's my 2000X getting some representation in the Origins line, sucker. I will say, you can't really get his staff to touch the ground, which is odd. I thought I got it to. Oh, because it's not in his hand all the way, stupid. Yeah, whatever. I don't care. It's sitting there. It looks fine. It looks fine! It's fine. It's fine for what we're about to do. And what we're about to do is going to blow your freaking minds, because you probably didn't expect me to do this after the upset that was the He-Man comparison. Yeah, I don't have a Motu Classics He-Man. Sue me. I'm not paying $100 for that guy. But here is the Origin Skeletor next to the OG. Complete with everything, even though I kind of would like to get a better sword. It's not broken, but does have some kind of chewed up mold marks on it. Kind of bug me. But it is old after all. But this is the original Hardhead Skeletor from the 80s. My He-Man, I didn't mention, was the squishy head version. Squishy, squishy. And I killed something. I don't know what that was. Oh, that's what that was. Well, you know what? You're just gonna have to hang out over there. and here is probably the best Skeletor to most people, at least at the moment, that new one that's supposed to come out. That's the same scale. Could possibly dethrone it, but I'm not sure yet. It needs to have some good ankle rockers, I think, like this guy does. But let me see. Let's get these moved over a bit. You can see my Skeletor party. Yeah, Skeletor party. But yeah, that's the Mochi Classics Skeletor. Thank you, Tebas. And actually, thank you to a few people. That was an endeavor, that Skeletor. It's an amazing creature, that figure. But nonetheless, it'll be cool to have like a bunch of Skeletors when that new one comes out. That new 7-inch scale, but I will say, I think the Origins is pretty close to being my favorite right now. I think it's cool. I think it's nice. I think it's sufficeable. If you can't afford classics, this line is gonna tick all those boxes for you, I think. I don't know. Middle-aged dudes are very picky when it comes to their childhoods, you know. So, yeah, there is that. And the camera is out of whack. Skeletor is off-center. Let's fix that. There go. Just look at that thing. It's an amazing creature. So, comparing it to two other favorite figures of mine. Here's Spawn. And here is Ghost Rider. At all the skulls. So many skulls. You like too many skulls, Overlord. That's because skulls are freaking sick. Yeah, Skeletor ain't touching that Spawn. That Spawn is like number one, numero uno right now, and it's quite fantastic. I mean, you need to buy this. You can get it at Target with an axe now. So just shut up and buy it. Quit questioning my authority and buy it. This Ghost Rider, you can't buy this anymore. Sorry, but he's long gone. It's way past clearance time for that thing. But yes, Skeletor is awesome. It's pretty much just been a Skeletor love fest this entire review. But that's what happens when Mattel gives a crap and makes a cool figure. I give it positive feedback. When you make a piece of crap, I will crap on it. That's how it works. I'm not going to shiny up the turd, I'm just going to add to said turd. Which this is not. This is amazing. I know some people think his face looks like an egg yolk, but it looks fine to me. I don't know. I guess it just doesn't bother me that much. I think it could be better. Yes, I always think things can be better. But for the price point, for what you're getting a mini comic, you're getting the classic style packaging, which I throw in the trash, but that's just me. You're getting the sword, you're getting the Havoc staff. I kind of wish you got an axe. The He-Man X in purple, which is coming with a later Skeletor figure, I believe, the Battle Armor deluxe figure. The shield too, I think. So you're gonna be getting plenty of Skeletor pieces to kind of trick this guy out, pimp this guy out, make him a little better. Even I think the Battle Armor comes with an extra head, so if you don't like the head on this, you could probably use the head from that, which surprisingly enough does look a lot like this. So, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this love fest, I mean review, and until next time, meow! I can't stop doing the classic Skeletor voice, which apparently, I don't think he's ever gotten, meow. I don't know, somebody Google it. I ain't doing that crap.